You know, this is a topic which is of utmost importance, but least discussed. As I was researching for this topic, I've seen very, very few articles, very few researches, very few books written on this topic. And hence, I would urge, you know, you, the members of the media, to take cognizance of this and start reporting it in your publications and reach this message out to your readers that women are 50% partners in life. Why are they not 50% partners in the personal financial planning? And as Ms. Kamini mentioned certain keywords, she said, let's shockproof our life. Let's look at empowerment of women. Let's talk about joy of freedom, having wills, not only having bigger GDPs for the country, but also bigger shopping budgets for ourselves. Then she spoke of partnership decisions. So this is, you know, we are going through a metamorphosis in Indian society. We see that women have now come shoulder to shoulder or ahead, whether it is CBSE exam results, whether it is career opportunities, whether it is sports. So in every space, women are shoulder to shoulder or ahead. And even our, you know, Prime Minister is speaking, you know, has several initiatives around women empowerment and strengthening the role of women in society. But in our space of wealth management, personal financial planning, we have not done enough. So today is an opportunity for us because we have several leading financial planners, you know, on this panel, and people who regularly speak to members of the public through media and directly. We have one of the leading asset management companies, mutual funds in India, and Birla Mutual Fund, which has more than 2 lakh crores of assets. And now, our industry association, you know, Association of Mutual Funds, which is the mother body of all mutual funds in India, they have close to 400 crores a year budget, you know, which is for investor education. So through you, Mr. Rao, you know, I'll send a message across to even so bodies like AMFI that a certain percentage of this budget, you know, should be dedicated to education of women, financial literacy and financial education for women. So the need, just to summarize that, the need cannot be overemphasized, and if women have taken a lead and charge in every other sphere of life, then why not personal finances? And why do we even need to think of you know, any untoward incident happening? Why any shock you know, becoming a wake up call for us? I think we need to be proactive, alert, and involve women in all financial decisions. Thank you.